Hi friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In my previous video, I discussed about one of the error detection method, that is parity check. Another error detection method is checksum. It is one of the important error detection method and have many advantages compared to other error detection methods. What is checksum? The name itself say the meaning of checksum. Check and sum, that is check plus sum. Checksum process have mainly two parts, that means in sender side checksum calculation and in receiver side checksum validation, that means checksum calculation. Two, checksum validation. Calculation at sender side and validation at receiver side. Mainly checksum has four steps. In sender side, first break the original message into k number of blocks with n bits. That means there are m size of a data. That means there is m bits in the data. Then we equally divide the message into k segment with n bits. For example, if there is a 16-bit data, that means 1000110111001. Then this is the 16-bit data. Then we divide this data into n bits equal. Number of n bits with the k segment, that is we divide this data into two blocks with the 8 bits. Sometime it may be 32 bits data. Then we can divide the 32 bit data into 4 equal segment, that means each segment contain 8 bit data. Next step is sum all the k data blocks. That means if in this example there are two blocks, then add these two blocks together, that means 1000110 added with the 1110011. This is the meaning of this second step. Next step is if any carry, add them to the sum. During the addition there is any carry, this carry is added to the sum. And last final step is the final sum is final sum's ones complement is called a checksum. That means after adding k blocks and if there is any carry, then add the carry with the sum and then we get final sum. Then we find the ones complement of last sum. This ones complement of final sum is called checksum. This is the first main step in the sender side, that means calculation of checksum. The final answer, that means once complemented sum is called checksum. Okay, checksum is added to the original data and sent to the receiver side. Then receiver check the checksum and he also calculate a checksum using the received data and he find the original data is received or not. Let me explain what happened in the receiver side. This is the main three steps in the receiver side. First, collect all the data blocks including checksum from the sender side. Then sum all the blocks and checksum, that means k segment of data added together, and finally the sum is added to the checksum received from the sender. This is the second step. In third step, if the result is all one, it accept, otherwise it reject. That means after adding the sum with the checksum, we get a sum. That sum containing ones. That sum containing all one in the bits, then the receiver can accept. That means the received data is original data. There is no error. But the bits containing ones and zeros, then we can understand there is error in the received message. That means the receiver reject the message. If the final sum containing all one in the bit position, then there is original message, and otherwise this reject. Let me explain this with an example. The data is given. So this is the data. First we want to calculate the checksum, then only the sender can add the checksum with data and send to the receiver. I am explaining the step by step process in sender side and receiver side. This is the given data, and in there is checksum calculation. Sender side in the checksum, first we want to calculate the checksum. For that, first we divide the data into k segment with the n number of bits. That means this is 32 bit data. I divided this data into 4 equal parts with the 8 bits. That means this is the data, and I divide this into 4. Add these blocks together is the second step. Then 10011001 added with 111000010. Then we get 110111110 and 1 carry. Then added this one here. 110 1 carry 110111110. Then this sum is added with the third segment, that is 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0. Then 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 is carry, and this one is added to the this one 1. Then again 0 0, then again carry 1 1 1 0. Then 1 1 added 1, there is carry, then 1, then also 1 carry, and then added this 1 to 0 0 0, then 1. This sum is added to the fourth block, that is 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0. That is 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 0, and 1 is carry, and then this one is added. Then 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 0. This is the final sum. Then we calculate the ones complement. That is, ones complement means zeros are changed to 1 and ones changed to 0. Then 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0, this is the ones complement. This is the final checksum. This checksum is appended with the original data and then sent to the receiver. That means the appended final message is 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0. This is the checksum. Then our original data is 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1, then 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0, and 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0. This is the original data. Checksum is added with the original data and sent to the receiver. Then receiver received this data, and receiver repeat the same process. That means receiver add the receiver first divide the original data part into equal blocks and equal number of bits blocks, and then the sum is blocked together, and the final sum is added with the checksum. Then we get an answer. This answer containing all bit with 1. Then the receiver accept the message. That means the message containing no error. If there is any change, then the receiver reject. Let me see what happened in the receiver side. in receiver side, receiver repeat the same process. That means these process are doing again. That means 1001100001 added with 1100010, then 1101110 and 1 carry. This one is added with this. This is 110. There is a carry 1. This carry is added 0111110. Then third block is added to this sum 100100. Then 0011101110. 1 carry 1103 ones, then 1 and 1 carry 110 and 1. Then fourth block is adding 0001 0010 0010 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 0 and 1 carry 1 adding 1 0 1 0 0 1 0 0. Then we get a final sum, and then added with checksum, or checksum is, this is our checksum. Then we added this checksum to the final sum. That means 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. That means we get a old bit with the 1. That means the receiver accept the message. There is no error in the received message. If for example we get 1 0 1 1 0 1 like that, then the receiver know there is an error in this message. This is the best method for finding burst error. But there is an another case, that means for example in the block this 1 is changed to 0, and this fourth block 0 is changed to 1. Then adding this, actually we get same sum, but the bits are changed. In this case the receiver cannot understand there is an error or not. This is the one disadvantage of this method. That's all. I hope all of you understand this checksum topic. It is very easy. If you guys enjoy this video, then like. If you have any queries, then comment it. Please subscribe my channel and share to your friends. Thank you.